Thank you, Carolina, for the introduction, and thank you for coming back. So, what we did yesterday, more or less, so we have the theorem by Bost, so this algebraic city criterion. It's okay, Enrica? Thank you. And so you start with a complex connected algebraic variety, so we are over C, but you assume that X is defined over a number field. So this is an important assumption that we will have to check. And you consider a foliation defined over the same number field, and you make a few assumptions. So you assume that your foliation G is P-closed for almost all times P. And you assume the existence of this complex manifold M satisfying the Liouville property. So as I said yesterday, just M is just a complex manifold satisfying the Liouville property that extends the graph of the foliation. So this sits inside X times X. And that's it. So if you have these assumptions, Bost proved that the foliation is algebraically integrable. Okay. So this is the theorem we want to apply to prove what it remains to do for the Bovill-Bogomolov decomposition theorem. So yesterday we start the proof of this statement. So the statement is the following. So you start with a complex projective variety with mild singularities. So you can do better, but I won't. You fix an ample class, and you suppose that you have a decomposition of the tangent sheaf into involutive subsheafs. So the GR is an E. And they have different types. So the GI are strongly stable. So this was introduced by Henri. Zero canonical class, and the second chain class is non-zero. And the E itself is just polystable, zero canonical class, but this time C2 has to be zero. So this is a flat part in the decomposition. And the conclusion is that E has to be algebraically integrable as well. So yesterday we started the proof. Let's continue. So as I said, we will assume that X is smooth. Just for simplicity. So what we proved yesterday is that this M satisfying the Liouville property exists. So that exists M. Satisfying the Liouville property. Extending the analytic graph of your foliation, not G, this is E. So this part is okay. So now we want to check the P-closeness. So I want to show that E is P-closed for almost all primes P. So I will use the notation of yesterday, but I will recall the notation. So R in C is a finitely generated Z algebra and such that you can choose a smooth projective model of X over the base, the spectrum of R. So spec R. You need to choose also models So G, I, and E, curly E, are models of your Felician GI and
E, so
I assume that these are contained in a relative tension space. So these are, again, foliations. So foliations. And shrinking R if necessary. We may assume that the canonical class is zero as well.
And what do we need?
Ah, yes, again. Geometric stability and semi-stability are open conditions. So may assume that, so if you look at what I called GIS bar yesterday, so this was the, so you look at GI and you restrict to the fiber over S bar. This should be the same S. So S is a, say, a closed point, and S bar is a geometric point. So you fix an algebraic closure. So you may assume that this guy is what? Stable will be enough. I will tell you why. And E, curly E, S bar, polystable. Polystable with respect to what? So you choose a model of X and say H, model of H. So this is an ample Cartier divisor on the total space, and this is with respect to H S bar, say. Okay, so we have to prove that this E S bar, when S is closed, is P closed, where P is the characteristic. So now let me recall you a part of Simpson correspondence in characteristic zero, because this is wrong in positive characteristic, but there is something else. And so, this is a small part. Huh? So that says that there exists an equivalence of category between the holomorphic flat bundles. So this is over C. Okay? So holomorphic flat bundles, so on X that is given, which are extension of unitary representation. And say this is an equivalence of category. Let's say in a different way. So X is given, and you fix H on pole. You choose. And on the opposite side, you consider semi-stable vector bundle, again on X, with C1, 0. So with C1, see. So this is the C1 squared vanishing C1, C1 squared, and C2. So this is exactly our E satisfies these assumptions. And in fact, what is more useful for us, this is also equivalent to the category of numerically flat vector bundle on X. So these are, say, NEF vector bundle with C1 0. Okay, these are the numerically flat. That this is not true in positive characteristics, so there is now a counterexample to something. Say, I will state something more precise. This is the. So now, positive characteristic. So this is a result that is due to Langer. So now X is defined over an algebraic closed field K, and the characteristic of K is P positive. And in this case, you have an equivalence of categories. You start the last one, so the numerically numerically flat vector bundles on X, this category is equivalent to the category of H. This is strongly semi-stable. Vector bundle, again on X. And as before, you need to have the C10, C1 squared, and the C2 of your vector bundles, okay? So here, there is this thing. So the difference is the strongly. So we already saw strongly something. So this is a completely different notion of strongly stability. So I think this is not a good idea to call these guys here strongly stable, but now this is done. And this is due to Kebekus, Greb, and Peternel. So what does it mean here, strongly stable? So in positive characteristic, so you can consider the absolute Frobenius. So this is just the identity on topological spaces. And this is the pif power on functions. OK, so and you say that E is strongly stable with respect to some Hampel class, if so E itself is not stable, but semi-stable. If E itself is semi-stable, then and more than that, when you pull back E by the absolute Frobenius, K times, this has to be still semi-stable. With respect to H. So it is not true in general that if you start with some E semi-stable, you pull it back by the Frobenius and you still get something semi-stable. This is wrong in general. So you require this to be true.
So exist K such
that?
Exist K such that?
No. Your thing. For any K. So K0 is allowed, and that means that E itself is semi-stable. Okay, this is for any K. So I said that this correspondence is wrong. Langer gave an example of a semi-stable vector bundle with this vanishing, but not nef. OK, so we want to apply this to our situation. So for the numerical data, it's OK. These are our assumptions. But this has to be checked. Okay, so in fact, this has already been done by Mehta and Ramanathan. This is in an 85 paper, and that says the following. So you work over a K k-bar, K algebraically closed, characteristic P positive. Now you have to assume that P is large enough with respect to, you start with X smooth projective. You fix H an ample class as usual, and you assume that P is larger than, say, R, that would be the rank, plus the dimension of X. So I will tell you. So suppose that TX is H semi-stable, semi-stable. And the important assumption is here, with slope non-negative. This is similar to the Shiger-Gromol assumption in some sense. And the conclusion is then any semi-stable vector bundle of rank, say at most R, is automatically strongly semi-stable. Okay. So in our situation, we get for free that our E is strongly semi-stable. So this is not difficult. And in fact, if you do not assume an X is smooth, one of the difficulties come from this statement. Because we don't have this statement for singular varieties, so one has to do something a bit different. Okay, so now it's okay. We have what we need to prove the P closeness. So let's see. So you start with S, a closed point. So you want to prove that curly E S bar is P closed. So what does it mean? It means that if you look at this map here, so you take a derivation here, you raise to the pth power, and you look at the class, you want to see that this map is identically zero. The first thing to note, so this is a fact that was known before. So if you pull back this by the Frobenius, and if you consider the induced map as this pth power, this is OX is bar linear. So if you want to understand what it means, that means that if you look at F1, D1, so D1 is a derivation here, F1 is a regular function. If you raise to the pth power, you have to prove that this is the same as F1P, D1P, plus F2P, D2P, mod curly E S bar. Okay, so this is the formula you have to prove, and this is not easy. But this is well known. So we have a linear map, and we want to show that this map is zero. Okay, so now, by assumption, this is nothing but the sum of the GI S bar. Okay, so suppose. So we argue by contradiction, and we assume that this map is non-zero. So if this is the case, this implies that there exists some I, some indices, some index, such that this one is non-zero. OK, but now, these are our assumptions and what we are assuming here. So by lemma, this one is semi-stable. slope 0. This is the Meta-Ramanathan lemma. This one is stable with slope 0 as well. Okay, so if you consider the image of this map, this is a non-trivial subshift of GI, D sub I. The slope of the image has to be non-negative because of this property, but at the same time, it has to be non-positive because of the stability here. And in fact, if it is non-positive, if it is 0, it has to be the whole gadget up to saturation. So the conclusion is that if this map is non-zero, in fact, it has to be surjective in codimension 1. Okay. Now, apply the result by Langer. Okay. So you know that C1 squared, C2 are 0. So by the lemma of Meta-Ramanathan, our E is strongly semi-stable. So Langer tells you that this gadget, this guy here, is numerically flat. So in particular, this is NEF with C1, 0. But since this is surjective in codimension 1, let's add some codes. This implies that GI S bar is NEF in codimension 1. As well, okay? But here again, C1 is 0. So forget the codimension 1. If you are NEF plus C1, 0, this almost immediately implies that C2 has to be 0 as well. And then you get a contradiction because by our assumptions, the GIs have non-zero C2. So this shows that our E is P closed for almost all primes P. Just a remark. So for the first and the second step of the proof, we have not used the fact that the GI are strongly stable. The only property we need is the stability. For 1 and 2, only needs stability of the GI. So we will only use the strong stability at the end of the proof. Okay, so now comes the last part. We have to reduce to number fields. So this is the third reduction. So this follows from these ideas. These are based on ideas from Andre, Yves Andre. it was not exactly the same statement, so you have to do something. But almost all the ideas are due to André. Okay, so how do we do? Exactly as in the case of the P closeness, we start with our algebra R, but now finitely generated over Q bar. So you, this is exactly as we did yesterday. So you look at the coefficients of the polynomials defining X, and you look at the QR algebra generated by this this coefficient. And so X will be now a smooth projective model over X over spec R. So this is not the same spec R as before, but should be okay. And again, GI E, all contained in a relative tangent, are models of the GI and E. And again, I will assume that, as before, I should not have erased this, but I can assume that GI S bar is a stable, and E S bar is polystable. Now again, S bar, say S is a closed point, but this time the residue field is Q bar. So that means exactly that over a closed point, the fiber is defined over a number field. Okay. So this time, now we can apply Bose theorem. We already proved that we have p-closeness, and we already proved that we have this complex manifold satisfying the Liouville property. So Bose theorem implies that E. E curly S bar as algebraic leaves. But this is for closed points, okay? And this is not what we want. We want to conclude that this is for the generic fiber. So now the question is, but I don't know the answer. Does this implies that E itself has algebraic leaves? I mean, in this case, we will prove that this is the case. But in general, if you start with a model of a foliation over Q bar, assuming that over closed point you have algebraic leaves, does this implies that the generic fiber, over the generic fiber, you have algebraic leaves? So this is not known, and I have no idea how to do it. And even in this particular case, I will do something different. So the first thing to do, and this requires some work, but it's not too difficult. One shows that E S bar is algebraically integrable, we have that its tangent bundle, E S bar, is etal trivializable. Okay, so that means that over a finite etal cover, this vector bundle becomes trivial. Okay, but the converse is not true. For sure, when you choose a vector field in an abelian variety, if the vector field is sufficiently general, this is et al trivializable, but it doesn't imply at all that the foliation is algebraically integrable. So this is a weaker condition here. So this can be proved. And yes, so and now the trouble is the fact that this et al covers on which ES bar is trivial may have degree that goes to infinity. So there is no control on the degree, on the degrees, when you change the point. And this is the main trouble. But the claim is that if you know this for all close point, this indeed implies that the same is true for the generic fiber. Then E itself is et al trivializable. Yes.
So S is a closed point of spec R, right?
Yeah.
What does it mean? Ks is cube R? I mean, Ks is the residue field?
Yes, the residue field of your closed point. This is an affine scheme over cube R. If you choose a closed point, you get a finite extension of the base field. So it has to be cube R. So let me give you an idea of how one can prove this, but it's just an idea. Okay, so the first the proof. So the first thing to do is some topology. So use a theorem of Jordan. I will tell you the theorem. To prove that there exists a finite et al cover of X such that when you pull back, so let me write this in this way. So for any close point in your base S, if you consider curly S bar and you pull it back to the corresponding fiber, this is a direct sum of line bundles. Okay. So in some sense, we do not know how to bound the degree of the et al cover on which it is trivializable. But here, at least, we have a bound on the degree of the et al covers here on which it becomes a direct sum of line bundles. And so this is an application of Jordan's theorem. So what is Jordan's theorem? This is just the following thing. So you start with a finite group contained in some linear group, GLN, and it says that there exists, there exists a subgroup A. Maybe A is not a good idea, A is an abelian variety, so a subgroup A, abelian, of index in G less or equal to something that depends only on the capital N here, okay? So when you are, where does this finite group come? E S bar is et al trivializable. So you can extend to the complex number if you want. That means on some et al cover it is trivial. So it is endowed naturally with a flat connection with finite monodromy. Okay, so you consider the representation. The image is always finite. And it takes value on the value of E at the point, so the rank is fixed. So if you apply Jordan's theorem to all the fibers over S, you get many, many subgroup of finite index. But in the end, you intersect all of them because the pi 1 of the fiber does not depend on the fiber. That's the point. So if you intersect all of them, you end up with a characteristic subgroup of the pi 1. And this does the job. Okay. Now, on each fibers, you have a bunch of line bundles. And the next step is to, in some sense, glue them together. So you don't glue, but this is what we have in mind, to have in mind. So. So the second part of the proof of this claim is you show that there exist L1, LR, line bundles. Now on X prime, such that such E itself. Is L1 plus LR. So this is a. In fact, this follows from the existence of a relative projective scheme. This follows from the existence of a projective. Here, the projectivity is the point. Projective moduli of Gizeker, semi-stable shifts over the base S. So the point is the projectivity of S. You also have to use the fact that the relative Picard scheme, in this case, is also projective. But this requires this type of statement. So this is not for free. And that says that, in some sense, all these line bundles over all this etal covers over the fibers, they all glue together to define global line bundles on the total space. This is not true, but this is the way to think about it. Now, by construction, if you take any of these line bundles and you restrict to the fiber of X prime S bar, so this is on X prime, you know that this is torsion. Okay, because we know that the sheaves ES bar has to be etal trivializable on some etal cover. So this implies that this gadget are torsion. And then the result follows from the Hilbert irreducibility theorem that says that there exist infinitely many closed points S in S such that the so-called specialization map, so you have the, say, peak zero of the generic fiber here. So this is the generic fiber. So the K is the quotient field of R. There is a specialization map. The same thing as, but at the close point. And Hilbert irreducibility theorem tells you that this map is injective, at least for infinitely many points. And this is enough to conclude that our Li are torsion. OK? So E is etal trivializable. So now this is the proof is almost finished.
So end of proof, so end of proof of the theorem. Let's say, may I assume, replacing x by a finite total cover, may I assume that E from the beginning is a trivial vector bundle, OK? This is where we are. So now you, so this E is a direct summon of this Tx. So you have a global vector fields. And what you can do is to consider the connected component of the automorphism group of X. So this has dimension. At least R, that may be bigger, but it doesn't matter. In fact, not, you will see. So this is an algebraic group. And in fact, in this case, this is an abelian variety. And the reason is that Kx is zero. OK, so by all the direct summon of zero canonical class of Kx is zero. And this guys, this x cannot be uniruled. So x is not uniruled. So this implies that by Chevalier decomposition theorem, that this structure theorem, sorry, that this ought is an abelian variety. And now there is a result of Michel here. He came exactly. The good time. So if you have an abelian variety acting on a projective algebraic variety, you know that there exists, so they call it A, that exists a quasi an étale cover. Everything is smooth here, so this is a étale cover of X of the type A times something. Moreover, but this is not needed here, this is equivariant. So you can split your variety into two pieces, but by the construction of this A, you know that, call it F, the pullback of your tangent shift here is certainly contained in a relative tangent over x1. OK? So, and now the only thing we have to check is that this is indeed an inequality. And so let me just write it. In fact, we have equality, and this is the only place where we use the fact that the GI are strongly stable. Okay, because if we don't have equality, that means that we have another vector fields. Okay, that gives you a section of one of the GIs, but they don't have sections because the GI are strongly stable. So this ends the proof of the theorem. That was longer than expected. Now I would like to say a few words about the Bouville-Bogomolov decomposition theorem. I mean, the singular version of the BB decomposition theorem. So this is due to, this is three papers, one by myself, then Greb, Guénancien, Quebecus, and Andreas, and Peter. And what we get is the following. So start with X, projective, a complex projective variety with KLT singularities and a zero canonical class. So say KX numerically trivial. Then there exists A, an abelian variety. There exists a decomposition, quasi-ital cover. Of X. So you can check that X1 has mild singularity as well. And another decomposition here. This is the product of, maybe I should have, no. I should put everything at the same time. Exists A. Pop. So there exists a decomposition. Of some quasi-ital cover. Of X. This, so this is an abelian variety. This we understand. This is of Calabi-Yau type. And this is of irreducible holomorphic type, but not in the usual sense. So this is a sense introduced by Henri. So here, you don't have any holomorphic form between the positive degree and up to the top. And here, essentially, you have a symplectic two form on the smooth locus that generates the algebra of forms. Okay. But what is missing is the topological condition. Okay, and this is the main. So there exists blah 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 blah. Yes. So the question and the main open problem is: are the pi one of the smooth locus of Yi and the same for Zj finite? Because to check that something is of Calabi-Yau type, you have to consider all the quasi-ital cover. This is not easy in practice. So this should be considered as a weak version of the Bovill-Bogomolov decomposition theorem. So just let me explain how we prove this using the five lectures. So the first thing to do, this is based on Henri's lecture. And the theorem above. So the algebraicity of the flat part. So algebraicity of the flat part and some techniques from analysis, so essentially computation of holonomy groups, implies that this was explained to us by Henri, that you have a quasi-ital cover here, an abelian variety, and here we don't have a decomposition, but just the infinitesimal version of it. So the tangent bundle is a sum of this should be the GI, correspond to the GI. So GI is a foliation. It is involutive. The canonical class is zero. The rank of GI is at least two. And the most important part is the, if you look at the symmetric powers of the GI, so including k equal to zero, this is stable. And in fact, this is even, stable is enough. strongly stable, in fact. Okay, so all the symmetric powers are stable. And in fact, from the proof, you can also check that the C2 of GI is in fact non-zero. Because in the algebraicity criterion, that is here, you put all the flat parts in the same piece. Okay. Now the C2 is non-zero. If you remember Andreas talk, this implies that the GI are algebraically integrable foliations. Okay. Now we need a splitting. So how do we split the variety? And this is another result. So I won't say anything because this is involved. So you start with a projective complex variety with mild singularity, say with KLT. And you consider on it G, so a weakly regular foliation. I don't want to say what is a weakly regular foliation, but at least as soon as you are a direct summon of a decomposition, you are automatically weakly regular. If X were smooth, this is regular in the usual sense. Okay, so this is just an extension of the notion of regularity to the singular varieties. But this is satisfied for free here. And suppose that the foliation J is algebraically integrable. So it has algebraic leaves, and this is the most important condition, because otherwise this is completely wrong. Suppose that the canonical class is zero. And this is exactly what we have here for our foliation. But you just need one of it. Then it says exactly what we need. There exists a decomposition of some quasi-etal cover of X such that, say, call it F. When you pull back, so this is a reflexive pullback, your foliation, this is precisely the projection. So it is given by a projection morphism. Okay. So here the important assumption is that the canonical class is zero. And this applies to this situation, because all the GIs are algebraically integrable. And you split the variety. And you end up with a honest decomposition. And now the fact that the factors are of Calabi-Yau type or irreducible holomorphic symplectic type follows again from the analytic part by Greb, Ganesiak, Evankus. Because as soon as you know the holomic group, you are done. You have only two types. So as soon as the variety is split, you apply again Greb, Ganesiak, Evankus, and you have the result. Okay, so I stop here.